अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम अब्दुल रहमान वासी, यू इंस्ट्रक्टर ऑफ फाइनेंशियल अकाउंटिंग 2. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक फॉर्म्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन आर फॉर्म्स ऑफ द ऑनरशिप. सो एज वी नो दैट देर आर मेजर थ्री फॉर्म्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस. वन इज सोल प्रोप्रेटरशिप, वन इज पार्टनरशिप एंड अदर वन इज कॉरपोरेशन. So in today's lecture, we will try to learn about these three forms of the business organizations. So let's start the topic. So now the topic forms of the business organization, forms of the business organization, business organization. Okay. So this is our today's topic for discussion, the forms of the business organization. As we know that a business organization or the ownership depends upon the basically consists on the three major forms of the business organization. One is sole proprietorship, one is one is sole proprietorship, and second one is partnership, and third one is corporation. So basically we have these three types of the business organizations, the forms of the business organization. One is sole proprietorship, second partnership, and third one is corporation. So as we are discussing in detail about these three forms of the business organizations, number one sole proprietorship, sole proprietorship, so as we know that a business owned by a one person is called sole proprietorship. A business owned by a one person is called sole proprietorship. So we can say that generally owned by one person. So as far as the sole proprietorship concerns, a business owned by a one person is called a sole proprietorship. So generally we can say that generally owned by a one person. So it is often small service type business or product oriented business. So it's often small, either service type business or product oriented business. So become as the sole proprietorship, this business is generally owned by a one person, is often small, either by the service type organization or the product oriented organization. Okay. So in this sole proprietorship, the owner of the business also act as the manager. So in this sole proprietorship, the owner of the business is also act as a manager. It means whatever the activities performed by the business, whatever the investment is made by the business, it just by the intelligence and by the hard working of the owner of the business. So whatever the activities which are done in the organization, in the business, just owner act like a manager in the sole proprietorship business. So you can say that number third, in this business, owner act as a manager. Okay. So it means all the activities performed by the owner, it means he is performing the activities as the manager. So whatever the activities performed by the owner, S like as manager, it means owner receives profits, comma, suffers losses and is personally liable. And basically the important point is that and is personally liable, for all debts or for all liabilities. So this in the business of the form of the sole proprietorship, generally owned by one person, often it's a small business, either service oriented type or product oriented type business or retail type business, owner act as a manager. So the whatever the activity performed by the owner in the business, it means he is performing that activity as a manager. So what kind of activities performed by the manager? These are the activities: owner receives profits from the business, suffers losses, and is personally liable for all debts. It means he is legally bound to pay all the debts of the business, all the liabilities of the business. So in this sense, we cannot say this is a limited liability business, because its business, its liability is too much high, and all the liabilities are bearded by the sole proprietorship, the owner of the business, which work as a manager in his own business. Therefore we can say that owner is responsible to pay all the debts, all the liabilities, in case of the bankruptcy, if the businesses go beyond from its profits. Okay. So no doubt, in fact, the sole proprietorship is by far the most common form of a business organization in our country. So in our country, in our economy, this sole proprietorship is a most common business. The people, they are investing, they are doing their businesses like a sole proprietorship in our country. So we can say this is a most common business in our country. So we can say this is a sole proprietorship is a most common business. Most common business in our economy or in our country. So as we know that in sole proprietorship, all the losses are bearded by the owner of the business.
all the liabilities or debts are paid by the owner of the business. Our owner is responsible to pay, legally responsible to pay all the debts, all the liabilities. Therefore, from an accounting point of view, if we are talking about the accounting point of view, a sole proprietorship is regarded as business entity separate from or the other affairs of its owner. So in accounting point of view, a business entity separate from the other affairs of its honor. So in this statement we can say that separate from the other affairs of its owner. So for this concern, for accounting point of view, this is very important point in the sole proprietorship, that in accounting point of view, a sole proprietorship is basically regarded as a business entity which is separate from the other affairs of its owner. So it means the other affairs, family affairs, the other tasks, the friendship or the relationships of the owner are not regarded in the business activities. So we can say the business activities are totally distinct activities, are the separate activities from the affairs of the owner. So all the things which are recorded in the business, these all activities will be concerned with this business. So whatever the other affairs of the owner, it means family affairs, their personal affairs, the friendship or the relationships and so, these are not included in this business because these are the distinct activities from this business. So we can say that this sole proprietorship business of the owner is, we can say it's a separate from the other affairs of its owner. So this is very important point. So note this point, that in the accounting point of view, we are not talking about the legal point of view. But at this point, we are talking about the accounting terms of the point of view, or the professional accounting point of view, that a sole proprietorship business is regarded as the separate from the other affairs of its owner. All the activities must be separated. All the business activities must be separated from the other affairs of its owner. So this is very important for the accounting point of view. It means if there are losses in the business, if there is a huge liability or debts which an owner is legally bound to pay, just he has to pay from his own business, but not from their personal properties as far as accounting point of view. But there is a lot of difference in legal point of view. This statement is basically accounting point of view. Basically, accounting point of view. Okay. This is basically accounting point of view. But as far as legal point of view, legal point of view, but legal point of view, there is some kind of distinction or difference between these two points. So you can check this. This point is basically accounting point of view, the separate from all the personal affairs from its owner. So the business is regarded as the separate from the all the personal affairs from this owner. But as far as the legal point of view, there is a little bit difference with this definition, this point. So, from a legal point of view, as per law, from the legal point of view, we can say that the business and its owner are not regarded as separate entities. But as previously we studied that in accounting point of view, the sole proprietorship business is regarded as a separate from the other affairs of its owner. But as far as legal point of view, it said that from a legal point of view, however, the business and its owner are not recorded as separate entities. So the business and owner are not recorded as separate entity. So this is very important. As far as accounting point of view, the sole proprietorship business is regarded as a separate from its owners. All the activities are separate from its owners. But in the legal point of view, the business is regarded as a business and owner are not regarded as a separate entity. It means they are business and owner are not regarded as a separate entity. They are not distinct to each other. Means all the debts or the liabilities, if the owner is responsible to pay, it means he can pay from their personal properties, from their personal rights. But as per accounting point of view, it's not necessary the business can pay from their personal activities. But legal point of view says that business and owner are not regarded as separate entity. They are not distinct to each other. It means this is equal, or these are the same things. So if in the case of the debts, it means owner is responsible to pay all the debts from their personal properties. If he is not fulfilled the debts from their investments, he is not fulfilled the debts from their businesses, it means he can manage their debts from their personal rights, from their personal properties, from their personal things. So we can say that in this point of view, the owner is personally liable to pay all debts. So this is very important. But as far as accounting point of view, owner is not personally liable to pay their debts from their personal resources, from their personal rights or personal properties, other than the business activities which is invested in the business, other than business activities. But as far as legal point of view, a law says that business and owner are not regarded as a separate entity. They are not distinct to each other. They are equal. So if in case of the liabilities, if in case of the debts, the owner is personally liable to pay all the debts. So how he can going to manage the debts? Either from their business or from their personal rights or from their personal properties, he can do. He can do and he has to do.